Hello everyone. In this video, we will be doing PCB designing of L293D IC. L293D is a DC motor driver IC which can control two DC motors in either direction. That is, we can control whether the DC motor can rotate in clockwise or anti-clockwise directions. Let's go ahead and open the datasheet of L293D IC. This is the datasheet. You can see that this chip can operate between 4.5 and 36 volts. It can deliver 600 milliamps of continuous current to DC motors and also 1.2 amps of non-continuous currents. Let's go ahead and start with the design. First, let's gather all the components we need. First, we need a 16-pin DIP for the L293D IC. Next, we need a 2-pin connector where we will connect our DC motors. This should be a big screw connector, which is also known as PVT connector. This will be of 5 mm pitch. We can find that in connectors. So we need two of these for two DC motors, and we will need one more for our power supply. Okay, I will just copy and paste it. Let's just switch off this default naming. Next, we need a 2-pin headers to connect the control signals. Pin number 2 and pin number 7 are the control signals for motor 1, that is 1A and 2A. And pin number 15 and pin number 10 are control signals for our second motor, that is 3A and 4A. Let's just add two pin headers. As shown in the data sheet, pin number 16 connects to VCC1. VCC1 can be between 4.5 to 7 volts. So let's just add 7805 IC, that is a 5 volt voltage regulator. This will be of TO220 package. Let's just add it on top. Then we have pin number 1 and pin number 9, which are the enable pins for both the DC motors. This has to be connected to 5 volt. We should connect this via a 10 kilo ohm resistors as shown here in the datasheet. Let's add two resistors. Let's rearrange the components. Let's place the components near to the respective pins. Now let's start naming all the components. Here we will connect our power supply, so that should be between 7 to 36 volts. This will be plus and minus, and it will be a DC power supply. This is motor 1. Let this be motor 2. These are control signals for both the motors. So let's just name them as A, B, C, and D. so that it becomes easy to refer to these pins while working with the board. And these are two 10 kilo ohm resistors, so let's just name them. This is of course a 7805 regulator. We can also do one more thing here, that is, since we have a 7805 regulator on board, we can use the 5 volt output from this board to any other board that we might connect to this board, as this board can be interfaced with a microcontroller or any other sensor board which also run on 5 volt. So we can use 5 volt from this regulator to power other boards. Let's just add a 3x2 pin header and name it plus and minus. Finally, we also need one 10 microfarad to 100 microfarad capacitor at the output of 7805 regulator. Now these are all the components we need. Let's just start wiring them. These center four pins are the ground pins, so let's just connect these four pins. Pin number 3 and pin number 6 are output for motor 1. Pin number 14 and pin number 11 are the output pins for motor 2. Pin number 2 and pin number 7 are control signals. They connect to the 2 pin header. Similarly, pin number 15 and pin number 10 are control signals which will connect to this 2 pin header. Pin number 16 connects to 5 volt. So let's just connect this to our output pin of the regulator. And this 5 volt is also going to our output header. And pin number 1 is connected to 5 volt via 10 k ohm resistor. Similarly, pin number 9 also connects to 5 volt via 10 k ohm resistor. Pin number 8 connects to the positive of the power supply. Negative of the power supply goes to the negative of the chip. Central pin of the regulator goes to negative, and pin number 1 of the regulator goes to positive of the power supply. Also, negative goes to our 3 pin output header. Finally, let's connect the capacitor to plus and minus 5 volt. All the wiring is done. Let's just rearrange some of the tracks, make it a little bit neat. Our DC motors withdraw a lot of current, so the tracks connecting to DC motors have to be thick. So let's just increase the thickness of the DC motor connections. And we should also increase the thickness of the power supply track. Thickness of the ground track should also be increased. Since DC motors draw a lot of current, the chip gets heated. So in order to reduce the heat, it is shown in the data sheet. We can use the copper area of the board as heat sink. By connecting the copper pore to the ground pins, that is these center four pins of the IC. So let's just put copper pore around the board. In order to identify the ground trace, let's change the color of the ground trace. Let's change it to yellow. Now this yellow color trace is our ground trace. And let's put the copper pore around it. Our yellow trace is net 0. So we have to connect copper 4 to net 0. Now you can see that entire copper 4 has changed its color to yellow. That means our copper 4 is now our ground trace. So these 4 center pins will now act as heat sink because they are also connected to the copper 4 at the bottom side. Let's just reduce some of the copper 4 area to reduce the size of the PCB. And you can see there are some small copper areas that are not connected anywhere. We can just remove them in properties. And now you can see all those small copper areas are removed. And let's increase the clearance between the traces and the copper pore to 0.6 mm. Now you can see there is some gap between the traces and the copper pore. Finally, let's put a board outline and see how big this PCB is. Our PCB is around 34 mm in width and 32 mm in length. Let's just quickly rearrange some of the text. Now this is the final size of our board. It is about 34 mm in width and 32 mm in length. Finally, let's do 3D visualization of the PCB. Let's go to Tools, 3D Preview and 3D Visualization. This is the 3D view of the PCB. This is how the PCB will look like after manufacturing. These are the two connectors where we'll connect the DC motors. These are the control signals ABCD coming from a microcontroller or any other digital chip. This is the 7805 regulator, 5 volt regulator. This will be a 10 microfarad to 100 microfarad capacitor. This is the output header where we can take 5 volt output to power any other boards. This is the power supply connector where we can connect a DC adapter or a battery pack. And this is the bottom layer where the soldering is done. I hope you like this. If you want to see me design any other PCB, a compact single layer or even a double layer PCB, you can mention in the comments. If you like this video, please like and consider subscribing to the channel. Thank you. See you again.